in Denny's camp. He had sent me something here and didn't even realize that this was possible and could be this way or this dangerous. But apparently there is something that Jbird is doing and doing a good bit that has got your boy Denny's concerned for you. And I believe a lot of what it has to do with is your intake and the amount of pizza that you are eating. Now, yesterday when we were talking about the things that you do that annoys Denny's, there was a discussion about that because you being a food bully, you pushing a food agenda on Denny's did come up. And he would say, just like every night or three nights in a row, like everything, it's pizza, it's pizza, it's pizza, it's pizza.
Denny's, he watched this pizza documentary that rattled him.
Yeah.
And then he asked me to come over. So we're working on something for the show. He's like, before we work, I just want to show you something. So he sits me down, and it's this pizza documentary about how this guy's addicted to pizza and how his life is spiraled out of control because of it.
And his health is a disaster. Because Denny's told me about it, too. He's worried.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. So what exactly did this documentary with this guy who's got his own pizza addiction say, and what was wrong with his health, Denny?
So I'll give you the gist. We're grabbing the audio right now. But the gist was this guy, since the age of 7, I believe, has only eaten pizza from that point forth. And the documentary takes place when he's 22. So he's been eating only pizza for breakfast, lunch, and dinner since 7 years old. And when he started hitting his 19 to early 20s, he started feeling, first he got migraines. He'd wake up, he had headaches, and then the migraines transitioned into vertigo to where he started losing where he was.
Huh.
And then the latest.
Who's been having vertigo that I know recently?
Yeah, Virginia, did someone not just say this morning, I've been getting dizzy a lot lately?
Yep.
I swear that came out of Jbird's mouth.
Those words were uttered by the bird.
That's the beginning phases.
And then the beginning is vertigo.
Vertigo is the beginning stages of pizza disease.
The end is death. Are you ready?
I would die for pizza. That's how strongly I feel for the pie.
Okay, here's a little bit about what that guy has to say, and this is part of the documentary of this dude and the health problems he was having because of pizza.
22-year-old Josh eats pizza 3 meals a day.
Some good stuff.
A total of 1,800 pounds every single year.
Wow.
80 times more than the average person.
Josh's pizza consumption is to excess. It's gotten to the point where it's a compulsion.
I crave pizza every time I want a meal. Right now I want pizza. I don't know what made me want it. I just want it.
He'll eat it hot, cold, one day old, frozen, microwaved.
Josh's only nutrition comes from the 2,000 cups of white flour, 250 cups of tomato sauce, and 230 pounds of cheese that he eats every year.
Wow.
God, I love the pizza.
Josh's diet concerns me, scares me really, because I feel like if it's left unchecked, that he is going to kill himself.
Wow.
Yes.
Oh, so this is like Denny's speaking, this documentary is speaking for Denny's. Where do you stand compared to this guy, Josh?
The whole time they're showing this guy, they're showing him in his kitchen. He's eating bagel bites. He's eating Hot Pockets. He's eating all these.
Anything pizza.
All these different kinds of people. Like, he's got a drug problem.
Well, so the problem is the amount of flour, the amount of salt, and the amount of sugar that's in these.
Yeah, oh yeah.
And you're eating it every day.
Yeah.
I mean, the only reason I even thought about it was that I think it's been 9 days straight of you just eating pizza. That's the only thing you've had for the last 9 days. I even talked about it yesterday. We only eat pizza.
Yeah.
It's gotten so hard to do.
Only nine?
Yeah. I thought he was about to call you and be like, no, I've had more than... No, he's saying more than nine.
I had a pizza blog last year. I love pizza. I do love pizza.
I think it's the only food you eat, though.
I go through pizza runs. I'm going through a pizza run right now.
I feel like you eat too much cheese to have the runs.
I eat other things. I swear.
Like what?
I don't have a problem.
But like hummus pizza. I mean, it's still essentially like pizza.
What else do you eat?
I eat a bunch of different stuff. I do. I eat hummus.
Pizza is what percentage of your total diet?
I eat butt chicken and seafood. I eat other... What did you ask me? I'm sorry. I feel like I'm on trial right now.
You are.
You eat Girl Scout cookies?
I eat healthy sometimes.
What do you eat that's healthy?
I will eat vegetables. I'll eat some fruits.
Okay. Yeah. Like, how when? Often do you have vegetables and fruits?
Virginia, yes. Quit acting been. Like... Yeah. Quit acting like you know what I do in my life.
Tell me the last vegetables you've seen Jbird eat.
I can't even remember. I mean, it was for a challenge. Remember that vegetable challenge?
He hates vegetables.
I was going to say, I don't know if I've ever seen you willingly eat a vegetable. In 15 years.
I feel like this is all getting misrepresented in the media right now.
Well, you're saying this, and everyone who knows you best has never seen you eat a vegetable.
I have.
Whenever you have an intervention with somebody, this is the first phase. Yeah. They get angry.
That's what it sounds
they
like.
They get defensive. Denial. And then eventually they're like, you're right, I do have a problem.
Acceptance.
So we just got to break him down.
I got pizza disease. I get it.
What percentage of your diet would you say is pizza?
I'd say that. 40%?
Oh, get out.
It's got to be 80.
Your nose just grew.
40 to 80%.
So 40 to 80.
I mix in others. I do, baby. I mix in other stuff. I like the
pineapple
pizza.
I like pineapple.
Denny's often and you get Jbird hot pineapple.
Oh, Hot Pockets are just pizzas.
Yeah, I know.
They're just little pizzas. They're half-circle pizza.
When the gremlin stops talking, I will answer your question, Kevin.
Yes. Yeah, so Denny's, when was the last time you've seen Jbird eat pineapple?
Gosh, I don't even recall. It's got to be a couple months.
You know that what happened to the cloak of night?
I know it's not pineapple.
So you're saying you go hide from Denny's and eat healthy.
Are
you trying to claim you go hide like in a closet in your house so Denny's can't see you eating vegetables and fruit? And you're like, thank God.
You're back on Mountain Dew, man. This has got 154% of your sugar in one serving of this.
I get it.
He's bringing numbers.
Denny's, you don't even think I like mango.
You barely ever eat mango. He randomly will get mango, I think, to throw people off his scent.
They can't question me. Look, I'm eating mango.
So infrequent.
Pizza gives me power. Okay,
well, I just have to know that your boy Dennys, he saw this documentary, he's concerned.
I was going to propose a challenge because I know Bird likes challenges.
Okay. Yeah,
okay.
How long could Bird go without eating pizza?
Okay. Oh, now we're in it, baby.
How many days?
Who put a nickel in you? Pipe down.
Inflation. It's a quarter.
Gosh, I mean, Dennys didn't ask for a hype man.
I love Denny's act.
I mean, everything Denny says, all you hear is Virginia.
How long could you go without eating pizza?
To prove I don't have a problem, I could go weeks. I could go weeks.
Yeah, weeks. Huh?
I could go weeks.
Okay, all right, so we'll go weeks then, since you say you can do that, no problem. So let's say no pizza until the 21st of February.
Should we give him one last supper, one last weekend? I know Bird doesn't like to start it on.
Oh, give me one last.
No, you can't do that.
Come on. That's I do with drugs sometimes to give you a little bit of, just to wean you off, don't they?
That's odd, because my wife works at a drug abuse foundation.
Drug place.
They don't shoot them up with heroin one last time before they check them in.
Baby, just give me one week.
Just one little more intravenous shot of heroin.
Oh, right.
Please.
Yes. Can I just have one more hit?
Come on.
Your Honor, please. Just hear me out for a second. Just hear my plea. My dad is in town from Texas. We're going to be going out to a very lovely pizza dinner.
Your dad eats healthy.
Nobody asked you. Oh, my gosh. I will give you $100 if you turn off your microphone for 3 minutes, Kevin. $100.
Okay. All right, that's good. All right.
Money well spent. Best money I spent in 2020. Seriously. Like I was saying.
Yeah, I mean, if you guys want to throw any more money at me, there's a lot. I'll turn off the whole show. I don't care. I'm up for that.
My dad is in town until Sunday. Yeah. Let me get one Italian dinner with him. Give me till Monday, and then I'll do your challenge.
Okay, 2 weeks starting on Monday. Okay, so then that would take it till starting on Monday, the 10th, no pizza till the 24th.
Ooh. Child's play.
And if anyone sees you eating pizza.
Okay, you bring your punishment on, whatever you want.
Then I think what it is he has to sit here on the show and eat a large amount of vegetables. We'll put whatever that might be, but you have to eat it all before you're allowed to walk up and leave. So that to me would be one suggestion for a punishment.
Okay.
Yeah.
Bring it.
Yeah.
Your punishments.
Or else Virginia can just punch you in the narcs.
Unlike some people on this show, I do my punishments. Oh, sudden death killer.
Her mic's still off for another minute.
I love it. She's in the penalty box. We should do this more often.
How much money you got?